What's up, YouTube? Today I'm going to discuss the Pusha T Drake rap beef that has the whole rap world going to frenzy. I'm going to discuss all the way back from how the feud started and how I got back reunited. Before I start the video, make sure y'all follow me on IG at DJQWave, Twitter at Godson4_, and make sure you hit that red subscribe button below. Now let's get to the video. The origin of this beef started all the way back in 2006 when rap duo Clips felt like Drake boss Lil Wayne was swagger jacking them by wearing bait clothing on the front cover on the Vibe magazine. Clips and their main producer Pharrell felt like the first ones rocking bait at the time. This led to subliminal shots fired at Wayne on the song Mr. Me Too with Malice Rap.
Want to know the time, better clock us. Cause bite the style from the shoes to the watches. We cloud hoppers, tailor suits like we mobs.
The video also showcased seven prototypes rocking bait. It was a long tail Wayne called to the sub shots. Wayne quickly responded on the interview with Complex in 2007. Wayne quoted, said, "I don't see no fucking clips. They had to do a song with us to get a hit," referring to the song What Happened to That Boy with feature Cash Money CEO Birdman. The beef got more heated years later when Pusha T sent out more subliminal shots on the track after this 23-1 to Lil Wayne, but he also decided to add Drake and Birdman in the mix. Pusha T spoke on Drake recording contract with Wayne and Wayne's with Cash Money and Universal Music. When Pusha raps,
"Contract all fucked up, I guess that means you all fucked up. You signed to one nigga, then signed to another nigga, then signed to three niggas, now that's bad luck. Damn that shit, even the odds now, you better off selling this hard now. You call it living out your dreams, you can't fly without your wings, you get it."
The diss prompted Lil Wayne to fire back at Pusha T on Twitter when he tweeted, "Fuck Pusha T and anybody that love him." Years later, Drake decided to fire back and defend Lil Wayne and himself at Pusha T in 2017 on the track Two Birds, One Stone, when Drake took aim at Pusha T's street reputation of being a drug kingpin before the rap. When Drake raps,
"But really it's you with all the drug dealer stories, it's gotta stop though. You made a couple chops and now you think you choppo. If you ask me though, you ain't lying in the trunk of kilos. You bagging weed, watching Pacino with all your zigging like this when we need to be on, but you never went live. You middleman in the bitch, boy, you was never them guys. I could tell cause I look most of you dead in your eyes. And you'll be trying to sell that story for the rest of your lives. Can't show us where the cash is. Me, I don't judge, I'm just going off what the math is. Numbers and..."
Pusha T didn't issue a response back to the diss until now, awaiting his new album titled Daytona, a track called Infrared Leap at a listener party, when Pusha T raps,
"Remember Will Smith won the first Grammy, and they ain't even recognize Hov until Annie. So I don't tap dance for the crackers and sing Manny, as I'm cold to juggle these flows and nose candy. Yeah, Ferrari my 40 and blew the candles out. Tom Brady, you niggas, I had to scramble out. They be riding these waves, I pull my sandals out. Had they Latin my Grammy, I went the Spanish route. Oh, now it's okay to..."
Questioning how Drake is the so-called best rapper, but he has a ghostwriter. Pusha added some more shots for Wayne and Birdman too. On the day of his album release, Pusha T joined the hype of the diss, also the new album hype, which many are calling a classic already. The Sis guy quickly dropped a diss song called Guppy Freestyle, sending shots at Pusha T. Drake starts off the song sounding annoyed and completely disgusted that Pusha T had the audacity to come at him again. Drake raps over the jazzy instrumental. He speaks on the accusation that he's a ghostwriter by alluding to the fact that he even wrote lyrics for the good music president Kanye West. Also, Drake raps, "Tell Ye we got an invoice coming to you considering we just saw another 24 hours after that." After that, Drake posts a photo on Instagram of an actual $100,000 invoice to the good music rapper for promotional assistance and career revival. Since to me, Drake wants all the smoke. Do you think Pusha T gonna respond back, or you think Drake eat to him? Comment your thoughts and make sure you hit the subscribe button down below to get more videos like this. Peace out.